and we'll have a good time, won't we? Let's stand at this time about the presence of the Lord in our midst. Heavenly Father, as we come before you, we do thank you for this and other opportunity that you have blessed us to be able, Lord, to assemble together in your house. We pray, God, you bless souls tonight, made an effort to be in your house, and we pray for those that would like to be in your house but are not able, that you would bless and comfort and strengthen them, dear Lord. Pray for each and every one, Lord, and their needs, God. I know that you, Lord, will meet every need, Lord, according to your riches in glory, Lord. Pray your will be done in this service, in Jesus' name, amen. Oh, come right on, get in.
Here we're often tossed and driven on the restless sea of time. Rolling clouds and howling tempests all succeed in bright sunshine. That land a perfect day when the mist is rolled away. We will understand it better by and by. By and by when the morning comes. All the saints of God are gathered home. We'll tell the story how we overcome. We'll understand it better by and by. We are often destitute of the things that life demands. Want of shelter and of food, thirsty hills and barren land. We're trusting in the Lord and according to His word. We will understand it better by and by. All the saints of God are gathered home. We'll tell the story how we overcome. We'll understand it better by and by. Trials hard on every hand. We cannot understand all the ways that God will lead us to that blessed promised land. He'll guide us with His eye, and we'll follow till we die. We will understand it better by and by. By and by, when the morning comes, all the saints of God are gathered home. We'll tell the story how we overcome. We'll understand it better by and by. Here temptation's hidden snare often takes us unaware. Our hearts are made to bleed by some thoughtless word or deed. We wonder why the test when we try to do our best. We'll understand it better by and by and by when the morning comes. All the saints of God are gathered home. We'll tell the story how we overcome. We'll understand it better by and by.
There are people almost everywhere whose hearts are all aflame with the fire fell at Pentecost, which made them all acclaim. It is burning now within my heart, all glory to His name. I'm glad that I can say I'm one of them, one of them, one of them,
one of them. Yes, one of them.
I am glad that I can say I'm one of them, one of them,
oh, one of them,
one of them,
yeah, one of them.
I am glad that I can say I'm one of them. Though these people may know
not learn to be, nor boast of worldly fame. They will receive their Pentecost through faith in Jesus' name. Nor telling them how far and wide His power is yet the same. I'm glad that I can say I'm one of them, one of them, one of them. I am glad that I can say I'm one of them, one of them, one of them. I am glad that I can say I'm one of them. They were gathered in the upper room, all praying in His name. They were baptized with the Holy Ghost, and power for service came. Now what He did for them that day, He'll do for you the same. I'm glad that I can say I'm one of them, one of them,
one of them,
one of them.
Yes, one of them.
I am glad that I can say I'm one of them, one of them,
one of them,
one of them.
Yes, one of them.
I am glad that I can say I'm one of them. Come, my brother, see this blessing that will cleanse your heart of sin. That will start the joy bells ringing, and will keep the soul aflame. It is burning now within my heart, all glory to His name. And I'm glad that I can say I'm one of them, one of them, one of them. I am glad that I can say I'm one of them. One of them,
oh, one of them,
one of them,
yes, one of them.
I am glad that I can say I'm one of them.
Thank you, Lord. Once like a bird in prison, I dwelt. No freedom from my sorrow, I fell. But Jesus came and listened to me, and glory to God, He set me free. He set me free, yes, He set me free. And He broke the bonds of prison for me. I'm glory bound, my Jesus to see. Glory to God, He set me free. Now I am climbing higher each day. Darkness of night has drifted away. My feet are planted on higher ground. Glory to God, I'm homeward bound. He set me free, yes, He set me free. He broke the bonds of prison for me. I'm glory bound, my Jesus to see. Glory to God, He set me free. Goodbye to sin
and things that confound. None of this world shall turn me around. Daily I'm working, I'm praying to. Glory to God, I'm going through. He set me free, yes, He set me free. He broke the bonds of prison for me. I'm glory bound, my Jesus to see. Glory to God, He set me free.
Yeah, once like a bird
In prison I dwell, no freedom from my sorrow I felt. But Jesus came and he listened to me. Oh, glory to God, he set me free. He set me free, yes, he set me free. He broke the bonds of prison for me. I'm glory bound, my Jesus, to see. Glory to God, he set me free.
Now I am climbing
higher each day. Darkness of night has drifted away. My feet are planted on higher ground. And glory to God, I'm homeward bound. Oh, he set me free. Yes, yes, he set me free. And he broke the bonds of prison for me. I'm glory bound, my Jesus, to see. For glory to God, he set me free.
Yes, the Lord.
What do you do? You can't feel Jesus. Can't see the roar or the storm where you're living. Can't seem to find real peace of mind. Should you give up? Finally surrender, but I hear a calm assurance and a quiet, gentle whisper saying, don't be afraid, I'm right here with you. You're not alone, I'll never leave, only believe. If you can't believe, all things are possible. Have faith in God, nothing's impossible. Just wait and see how God's gonna move. He's done it for others, he'll do it for you. Don't ever give up, keep on believing. Won't take him long, you'll soon be receiving. Walking by faith, it's all in God's grace. Only believe. Heard them all say, all that it takes is just a little mustard seed of faith. Speak to your mountain, be thou removed. That kind of faith shouldn't be hard to do. But I find myself standing the base of my trial. Now's not the time for my faith in denial. Know the God that I serve sent forth this word. That's why I believe. If you can believe, all things are possible. Have faith in God, nothing's impossible. Just wait and see how God's gonna move. He's done it for others, he'll do it for you. Don't ever give up, keep on believing. Won't take him long, you'll soon be receiving. Walking by faith, it's all in God's grace. Only believe. You can believe, all things are possible. Have faith in God, nothing's impossible. Just wait and see how God's gonna move. He's done it for others, he'll do it for you. Don't ever give up, keep on believing. Won't take him long, you'll soon be receiving. Walking by faith, it's all in God's grace. Only believe.
You know, it seems like so many people are sick. And I know that past 3 days, I had to go for a barium swallow test. I don't know if y'all have ever had that done, but I have been sick ever since I took that thing. I had to drink that old chalky stuff, and I'm just like, and last night I was so sick, and the Lord just reached down and just helped me to be able to do what I needed to do today for my little people that I work for, and I just thank the Lord for that. And I could not, if it was not for the Lord, I couldn't do what I do. Because a lot of people, when you go into their homes, you've got a lot to do, and you know they expect a lot out of you. But I'm just so thankful that the Lord helps me to do what I have to do. And I'm so thankful for the many times that I've cried out to Him, and He's been there. I'm going to try to sing this song.
Living below in this old sinful world, hardly a comfort can afford. Striving alone to face temptation's sore, where could I go but to the Lord? Where could I go? Oh, seeking a refuge for my soul, needing a friend to save me in the end. Where could I go but to the Lord? Neighbors are kind, I love them. We get along in sweet accord. But when my soul needs manna from above, where could I go but to the Lord? Where could I go? So dear, comfort I get from God's own word. Yet when I face the chilly hand of death, where could I go but to the Lord? Where could I go? Seeking a refuge for my soul, needing a friend to save me in the end. Where could I go over to the Lord?
Sometime we misgivings darken the day, and face life I cannot see. I ask my dear Lord to brighten the way. He whispers sweet peace to me. He whispers sweet peace to me. Bless God. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, He whispers sweet peace to me.
this town in spirit and soul. He whispers sweet peace to me. I could not go on without him. I know the world would overwhelm my soul, for I could not see the right way to go when temptations hold me wrong. He whispers sweet peace to me. Bless your name. Oh, he whispers sweet peace to me when I am cast down in spirit and soul. He whispers sweet peace to me. I trust him through faith, by faith hold his hand. But sometimes my faith is weak, and then when I ask him to take command, it seems that I hear him speak. Then he whispers sweet peace to me. Bless the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, he whispers sweet peace to me when I am cast down in spirit and soul. He whispers sweet peace to me. Thank you, Jesus. He speaks in a still small voice, we are told. It's a voice that dispels all fear. And when I'm in doubt or I'm troubled in my soul, that still small voice, thank God, I can, glory be to your name, Jesus. Then he whispers sweet peace to me. Bless the Lord, glory. Oh, he whispers sweet peace to me when I am cast down in spirit and soul. He whispers sweet peace to me. He speaks in a still small voice, we are told. It's a voice that dispels all fear. Thank God. Bless the Lord. And when I'm in doubt or I'm troubled in my soul, that still small voice I can hear. Then he whispers sweet peace, bless the Lord, to me. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, he whispers sweet peace to me when I am cast down in spirit and soul. He whispers sweet peace to He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. Whoa, 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 on-time God. Yes, He is. Yes, He is. He may not come when you want Him, but He'll be there right on time. He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. You can ask the children of Israel, trapped at the Red Sea, by that mean old Pharaoh and his army. Well, they had water all around them, and old Pharaoh at their back. From out of nowhere, God stepped in and cut a highway just like that. Yeah, He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. Whoa, on-time God. Yes, He is. Yes, He is. He may not come when you want Him, but He'll be there right on time. He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. You can ask Mary and Martha. Their brother Lazarus was sick in bed. They cried, Jesus, please heal him. But Jesus waited till he was dead. They said, Lord, don't understand it. Why you waited till now to come? But Jesus said, Lazarus, come forth. And death let him go. And he came walking out of the tomb. Hallelujah. Well, He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. Whoa, on-time God. Yes, He is. Yes, He is. He may not come when you want Him, but He'll be there right on time. He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. You can ask the three Hebrew children when thrown into the fire. And O King Nebuchadnezzar, he cut up the furnace 7 times higher. Well, when they were amongst those flames, I tell you what they did find. They found Jesus walking in with them, yes. And my Lord was right on time. Woo! He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. Yes, He is. He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. Yes, He is. He may not come when you want Him, but He'll be there right on time. He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. He's on time. He's on time. He's on time. Oh, yes, He's on time. He's on time. He's on time. He's on time. Oh, yes, He's on time. He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. Yes, He is. He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. Yes, He is. He may not come when you want Him, but He'll be there right on time. He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. Well, He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. Oh, thank you, Lord. He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. Yes, He is. He may not come when you want Him, but He'll be there right on time. He's an on-time God. He's an on-time God. He's an on-time God. Yes, He is.
Man, even when they, in the Bible, when they thought Lazarus, there was no hope that he would ever live on this side again, Jesus had other thoughts, didn't he? He went to the tomb where Lazarus lay, and he called him by name, didn't he? If he had said, the dead rise, they'd all rose up. Amen. But he called him by his name. Said, Lazarus, come forth. And when he called him, first he prayed. Amen. And then he called him to come out of the tomb. But he told them before he, amen, called him out, he said, remove the stone, roll it away. The Lord tonight, he wants us to get the obstacles out of the way. And when we, amen, put all those things aside that would hinder, amen, us from receiving what God has in store for us, I believe we'd be amazed at what the Lord can do. He ain't quit moving, has he? Amen. And tonight, amen, he ain't give up on us, and I don't want to give up on him. Never, ever, amen. I want to hold on to the promises of his word. Yeah. It's going to be worth it in the end if we stay faithful unto the Lord. Amen. I thought tonight as we look into the word of God and begin to consider, amen, all the good things that the Lord has promised his people, the benefits that we have tonight, amen, in serving the Lord. We've got somebody to turn to in a time of trouble, and he's also there in the good times. I want him in the good times, and I definitely, amen, want him to come when I call upon his name. He's not far off unless we would walk away from him. He's near unto us. He's as close as we'll let him be, ain't he? Amen. The more we meditate on him, the more we call upon him, the closer that he'll be unto us. Praise God this evening. Amen. We do ask for your prayers tonight. Maybe we could say something and be a blessing to you. Amen. We're living in perilous times, but it's a good time to serve the Lord. Amen. Good time tonight to let our light shine before others that they can see the Christ in our life. If you have your Bible, you want to turn with us for just a few minutes. Let's go to the book of 1 Peter chapter 4. And beginning at verse 1, we'll start there in the first verse of chapter 4 of 1 Peter. Amen. I thought tonight, amen, the price that the Lord paid that you and I could have, amen, redemption from our sins, that we would not have to live without hope in our heart to know that there is a better life in the Lord, that there would be no change, that we could ever be saved. He, amen, tore down that wall of partition that kept us from the mercies of God, that we with boldness could come to the throne of grace. Amen. And we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in a time of need. Praise God tonight. I thought, amen, I was reading there about our high priest. He was made a high priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. And tonight, amen, he is touched with the feeling of our infirmities. He was tempted in all points as ye, the Bible said, yet without sin. Amen. I'm so glad tonight that he knows what we're going through. He knows what we face, and he's able to see us through. Amen, those times in our life, those trying times. But the Bible said, amen, in verse 1 of 1 Peter chapter 4, for as much then as Christ hath suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourselves likewise with the same mind. For he that hath suffered in the flesh has ceased from sin, that he no longer should live the rest of his time in the flesh to the lust of men, but to the will of God. For the time past of our life may suffice us to have wrought the will of the Gentiles when we walked in lasciviousness, lust, excess of wine, revelings, banquetings, and abominable idolatries, wherein they think it strange that ye run not with them to the same excess of right, speaking evil of you. Who shall give account to him that is ready to judge the quick and the dead? For this cause was the gospel preached also to them that are dead, that they might be judged according to men in the flesh, but live according to God in the Spirit. Amen. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, as we come before you this evening, I do ask and pray as we stand here to present ourselves unto you tonight, that you, Lord, would drop the words into our spirit, into our heart, that you would have for us to speak this evening. We do not lean to our own understanding, but we lean, God, upon you, Lord, to direct our heart and to instruct us and send tonight that you would see necessary for encouragement, for strength, and uplifting in this trying hour that we're living within. We know that we're living in the last days, but may we live true before you, walk upright in your sight, that we may be accepted in you, unto you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. I thought tonight, church, as we considered the price that Jesus paid for us, amen, that we could have this good salvation tonight that we have and enjoy. Amen. It did not come, amen, at a small price. Amen. Jesus suffered greatly in the flesh that you and I, amen, could be freed from a life of sin. Amen. I thought as we began to look to the Word of God and the Scripture begins to enlighten us to just what the Lord went through for each one of us. Amen. He was perfect. There was no guile ever found in his mouth. He never committed a sin. He walked perfect. Amen. All the time that he was upon the face of this earth. Amen. He was the Son of God, but he took upon himself the role of an earthly man. Amen. He faced the same devil that we face tonight. Amen. He was tempted in all points as ye, yet without sin. Amen. He never sinned. Amen. I thought, amen, as Isaiah began to make reference to the sufferings of the coming Messiah at that time in Bible history, amen. And Isaiah wrote, he said, I gave my back to the smiters and my cheeks to them that plucked off the hair. I hid not my face from shame and spitting. Amen. Now it would take a lot of humility, of humbleness, to stand before those that despised him. Amen. And endure, amen, the suffering that he went through. They mistreated him, amen, treated him, amen, as though that he was a dog. But he faced it all that you and I could be free from sin. Amen. The Bible said, amen, in Isaiah 53 and verse 5, amen. And another reference to the sufferings, amen, of Jesus. He was wounded, the Bible said, for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. Amen. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes we are healed. Amen. Thank God tonight. Those are words tonight that a man should make each one realize how much he really loves us. that he was willing, amen, to take the pain and the suffering that he endured. Even though that he prayed, amen, fervently unto the Father that if it would be possible that the cup of bitterness would pass from him. But he was willing to taste of that bitter cup. Amen. Endure the pain and the suffering. Go through all that he went through. Amen. Go to Calvary's hill. Amen. And bleed and die for the sins of the world. But thank God, I'm glad that he come back, amen, on that third and appointed day and appeared, amen, unto his disciples as proof, amen, that he had risen. Amen, that he was no longer in the tomb. Amen, that he was alive forevermore. I thought, amen, in the place where Jesus spoke to his disciples, he said, you can destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up again. He wasn't speaking of the magnificent buildings there in the city of Jerusalem. Amen. They thought that was what he was referring to. Amen. They said 46 years was our fathers in building these, amen, great buildings. And you say within 3 days, amen, them being destroyed, that you could raise them up again. He wasn't talking about buildings that were constructed by man's hand. He was speaking of his own body, amen, that in 3 days after his death, that he would rise again, thank God. And because that he came back as a first fruit of those that sleep, you and I have hope tonight that we will live with him throughout eternal ages. Praise God tonight. Amen. He took the beating upon his back that we were all worthy, amen, of. But yet, he took our place. Amen. I appreciate him this evening. I want to show that appreciation unto him. And amen. Give him the praise and the honor that is due unto him each and every day. You know, tonight as we begin to magnify the Lord in our heart and sing songs of praise unto him, lift up his holy name, amen, it delights the Lord. It pleases him. And in so doing, he shares his blessings upon our lives. Amen. I thought, amen, the Bible talking about the sufferings of Christ there, amen, as he hung upon that old rugged cross on Golgotha's hill. The Bible said the ninth hour that Jesus cried with a loud voice in Mark 15:34. Amen. He said, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, which is being interpreted, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Yeah. Amen. Have you ever felt forsaken? No doubt, amen, that someone down through your life may have forsaken you. Amen. They may have said, I'll be there. Amen. And when you needed them, you could not find them. But the Lord will never forsake us, will he? Amen. But as Jesus hung upon the cross, he experienced that feeling. Amen. That even the Father himself would turn his face away. But it was not for long, just for a little while. Thank God tonight, you know, no doubt, amen, the Father, amen, could not look upon, amen, what was going on beneath him as he, amen, observed the sufferings of the Lord. Yeah. Amen. Jesus, the Bible said that he could have called more than 12 legions of angels, amen, that would have bore him up. amen, and delivered him from, amen, the torment that he was enduring. But he chose rather to die for our sins. Thank God tonight. We tonight have not paid so great a price, amen, as of yet. Amen, we've not resisted unto blood, most of us, amen, in this country as of yet has not resisted unto blood, striving against sin. There are those that have, and even today, there are those, amen, that endure great persecution for their faith in Christ and for the testimony that they have, amen, of their appreciation of the Lord. Amen. And tonight, I've thought, church, amen, we don't know what we'll have to face before we leave here. But we know this. No matter what may come, amen, it'll be worth it all. Amen. If we suffer with him, the Bible said we shall also reign with him. Look at the scripture, amen. For as much then, amen, as Christ has suffered for us in the flesh, amen, arm yourself likewise with the same mind. Yeah. Amen. Tonight, church, there are those that will despise you, not because you have done them wrong, but, amen, simply because that you are a child of God, amen, that you serve the Lord, and that you, amen, are a professing Christian, amen, not ashamed of the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Satan denied, he will try every way possible to discourage us in our walk with the Lord. And, amen, he tries his best to weigh us down with the troubles and the problems of this world. But I'm glad tonight, church, amen, that we have one that we can cast our cares upon, because he does care for us, don't he? Amen. He was willing to take our sin, amen, and bear those sins to Calvary's cross. Amen. Our hope is in the risen Savior tonight. Amen. He's not on the cross anymore. He's not in that barred tomb, but he's alive forevermore. Amen. When the women returned from the graveyard, they went running back to the city to tell his disciples, he is risen. He is not in the tomb. Amen. He is alive. They could not believe it, amen, at that time, that he had come back from, amen, what they saw just a few days before as he hung on the cross. Amen. No doubt he was beaten beyond recognition, amen, but he went all the way for us, and I want to go all the way for him tonight. I want to endure to the very end, amen, that I may hear him say, well done. Amen. Arm yourself likewise with the same mind. For he that has suffered in the flesh has ceased from sin. Amen. Satan may attack you in your flesh. Amen. He may try to get you down if he can. But you rise up each day in the name of Jesus. And do you declare, I've got victory in the name of the Lord. Amen. He shed his blood that I could be free of sin. He bore the stripes upon his back for my healing. Amen. He is my deliverer. He is a very present help in a time of need. Amen. The Bible says that he no longer should live the rest of his time in the flesh to the lust of men, but to the will of God. We're not slaves to sin any longer. were the children of God. Amen. Sin has no dominion over us. Amen. We don't have to take our orders from Satan. We take our orders from God. Amen. The Bible said this, whom the Son sets free, he is free indeed. Amen. And there's no reason, no excuse to ever return back to the things that we left behind, because there's nothing back there worth going back for. Amen. Our prize lays before us tonight. And I want to run that race with patience. Amen. That is set before me, that I may obtain the goal. Praise God tonight. When I close my eyes in death, amen, my spirit will go back to God that gave it. Amen. The paradise of God, where the souls of the saints rest, amen, until that day when they will come back with the Lord to receive those, amen, that are upon this earth. Amen, into his presence. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. It's going to be a wonderful day, ain't it? Amen. When we can all gather together around the throne of God. Amen. And we will be able to sing a song. Amen. That the angels that themselves will not be able to sing. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. My sins, amen, are forgiven. Amen. I have been bought by a price. Amen. And I'm none of my own. Praise God tonight. I was a slave to sin. Amen. But he set me free. Praise God. Hallelujah. And tonight I can call him Father, because he calls me his child. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. He loves this church. He cares about us. Amen. Right down to the very minute, amen, parts of our life that others may, amen, not even think about. The Lord is concerned about those things that are in our life. Amen. No matter how small or great it may seem, the Lord is concerned. But I want to arm myself with a Christ-like mind, as the Bible instructs me. Amen. For he that has suffered in the flesh has ceased from sin. Yes, Satan will attack you. Amen. He'll try to make you sick, even take your life. But praise the Lord, tonight I'll be here till the Lord gets ready for me. And when he gets ready for me, it don't matter what they try to do to keep me here, I'll be going home. Praise the Lord. Amen. I thought about that song, everybody wants to go to heaven, but nobody don't want to die. Well, amen, I guess you know that is something in us. We want to live as long as we can, but a time will probably come, if the Lord don't come first, that we'll leave here, amen, by the route of the grave. But I can say this tonight, death, amen, will not have dominion over us. Amen, death tonight, the last enemy that'll be destroyed is death. And death and hell are going to be delivered up and cast into the lake of fire. We're going to live on. We're going to a place where we will never die. There'll be no sad goodbyes in that land. Praise God. Everybody, that song said everybody will be happy over there. I believe that tonight. I believe, amen, that there will be nothing but smiles in heaven. Amen. A peace and a rest that we have never known before. It'll be worth it all. My child, it'll be worth it all. Amen. The Bible tells us that he should no longer live the rest of his time in the flesh to the lust of men, under the dominance of sin, under, amen, the rule of Satan. But we are the children of God, and we serve the Lord. Amen. But he didn't call us servants. The Lord didn't. He called us friends. Amen. I believe tonight he invites us to the table to sit and dine upon, amen, the best that heaven has to offer, that we may be filled with the blessings of the Lord. Tonight we can have joy in our soul tonight in a troubled world. We can find peace in the Lord in a time of great trouble and sorrow. Tonight, I don't despair looking around me and seeing the condition of the world. I've got hope that the Lord is coming soon. I'm looking for him to come just any day now. Amen. I don't know exactly the time that he will come, but I do know this. The Lord is coming soon. Amen. We do not live as we once did. We do not walk. Amen. According to the lust of the flesh and fulfilling the lust of the fleshly man. Amen. There are those tonight that desire, amen, the rudiments of this world. They desire that the world has to offer. That does not satisfy me at all. I have no desire for those things. Amen. I seek that which cometh from above. Amen. Thank God every good and perfect gift is from God and cometh down from the Father of lights, in whom there is no variableness, neither shadow of turning in him. Amen. He's not one way today and some other way tomorrow. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore, and he changeth not. What he said he meant, and what he meant he said. Praise God tonight. Amen. He has a storehouse of goods, amen, for us tonight. And I believe at times he opens up the windows of heaven and shares his good blessings down upon his people to enrich our lives and to encourage us, amen, to hold on and endure, amen, the hardness. Be as a good soldier, endure that hardness. Stand strong for God, for there is a reward for those, amen, that endure unto the end. I tried my best this evening. I hope maybe we said something that was a blessing to you. You know, tonight the world may look upon us and wonder why that we do not participate in the things that they count as, amen, a good time. Well, that don't satisfy me. I've got a taste of something far better. Amen. I have tasted the Lord. I found him to be good. Yeah. There's nothing that can compare with the blessings of God. To be able to feel the Spirit of the Lord engulf your life, your soul, your very being, and just manifest himself through you. There's no greater feeling. I believe, amen, at those times that, amen, heaven comes down upon us, amen, and enriches our souls. Amen. Praise the Lord. Encourages us, strengthens us to be able to take that next step. Church, there's one thing for certain. We're on a journey, amen, and we're on our way to a better land. Amen. We're pressing forward in this tonight. Amen. Looking for the Lord to come just any day now. Yeah. Amen. And he is a coming. Praise the Lord. I want to be ready. Amen. Whether he would come first or whether I would go by the route of the grave. Amen. I want to be ready. That's the main thing, ain't it? Be ready to meet the Lord tonight. I wish the whole world would come to realize, amen, that they can have the Lord in their life. And if once a person has experienced the Lord, I don't see how that anything else could, amen, could satisfy them. That the things of the world, how could they satisfy one after they have tasted of the Lord and of his goodness, of his sweet spirit, and, amen, participated in his word. Lord have mercy. There's nowhere else to turn but to the Lord. Amen. Where could I go tonight but unto him? And I definitely want to go to him. Call upon him. Believe in him. Trust in him. Amen, because he will see us through. God bless you. Amen, as they sing. Let's pray. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Shackled by a heavy burden, neath the load of guilt and shame, then the hand of Jesus touched me, and now I am no longer the same. He touched me, oh, he touched me, and all the joy that floods my soul, something happened, and now I know he touched me and made me whole. Since I met this blessed Savior, since he cleansed and made me whole, I will never cease to praise him. I will shout it while eternity rolls. He touched me, oh, he touched me. And all the joy that floods my soul, something happened, and now I know he touched me and he made me whole. Oh, he touched me, and all the joy that floods my soul, something wonderful happened, and now I know he touched me, and he made since I met this blessed Savior, since he cleansed and made me whole, I will never cease to praise him. I will shout it while eternity rolls. He touched me, oh, he touched me, and all the joy that floods my soul, something wonderful happened, and now I know
touched me and he made me whole.
What would we ever do without the Lord? He wants us to lean on him, don't he?
Yes.
Wants us to trust in him. He's a God that cannot fail. I've failed, but he has never. I've made mistakes and come short. Look back over my life and said, Lord, you've been awful good to put up with me.
Yeah.
But the Lord's good to us, ain't he? He's gentle and merciful unto us. Lord, if he wasn't a God of compassion, I'm glad that his grace is so great. If he had have dealt justice to us, we had every one been in hell.
Amen.
But his grace was so great that he was willing to give us that opportunity.
Yeah.
I thank him. Amen. I may not know much, but I know everything. I know the Lord, and I appreciate him tonight. Remember the service Wednesday night. Over the coming weekend, be very much in prayer for these services. And if we don't meet again here, we'll meet over yonder,
yes,
won't we?
Amen.
God bless you is our prayer. Remember all the requests tonight, those that are hurting in their spirit. The Lord is our comfort. He is our help. And those tonight that need a touch of God, let's just pray and believe for miracles. Because Satan can do no more than God would allow him to do. And if we will call on the Lord, he will intervene. I know he will. Thank God. God bless you. I stand and thank the Lord for this service. Heavenly Father, we thank you.
We shall meet on that.